Greetings. This video refutes argument number 2 from the random flood list sent by the Mohammedan. Let's look at the claim of argument 2. According to the Word of God, the Bible, Jesus is a curse and cursed God. Galatians 3:13. But according to Muhammad's Quran, Jesus is a blessed prophet. Consider the purpose of this argument. It is trying to imply Islam is somehow better than Christianity because the Quran says Jesus was blessed and the word cursed is mentioned in the Bible regarding Jesus. Notice the claim made in argument 2. Jesus was a curse and Jesus cursed God. According to the Word of God, the Bible, Jesus is a curse and cursed God. That's the exact text the Mohammedan sent to me. But let's look at what Galatians 3:13 actually says. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, cursed is every one that hangeth on a tree. King James Version. The Messiah redeemed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse for us, for it is written, a curse on everyone who is hung on a tree. That's the International Standard Version. Christ has made us free from the curse of the law, having become a curse for us. Because it is said in the writings, a curse on everyone who is put to death by hanging on a tree. That's the Bible in basic English. Notice the first damning problem for argument 2. Galatians 3:13 does not say Jesus cursed God. So claim number 2 is a bold-faced lie from the very start. The Bible does not say that Jesus cursed God. Now that will only matter to you if you place any value on truth, if you place any value in honesty. But Galatians 3:13 does say Jesus became a curse. Unless you understand what this means, you will make the same mistake this Mohammedan has made. He thinks this is a bad thing. He thinks it is bad that Jesus became a curse for us. So let's look and learn what this really means. Galatians 3:13. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. Simply stated, the curse of the law is the penalty or punishment for breaking God's law. The salvation which God offers to you is to pay the penalty of your sin for you. God has, in fact, already paid your penalty for you. Jesus allowed himself to be cursed for you, so that you would not be cursed. How was Jesus cursed? He was crucified. Crucifixion is a curse as stated in the Word of God. Deuteronomy 21:22-23. And if a man has committed a sin worthy of death, and he is put to death, and you hang him on a tree, his corpse shall not hang all night on the tree, but you shall surely bury him on the same day. For he who is hanged is accursed of God. So this is the correct understanding of Galatians 3:13. Jesus allowed himself to be cursed for you, so that you would not be cursed. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.